decided to cook again. I'm challenging myself to make ramen because that's something I've never eaten, and on the packaging it just looks extremely delicious. So wish me luck and let's go. I actually watched some stuff on YouTube which is very complicated without the actual noodles. So I bought mushrooms, spring onions, lemon, corn, sesame seeds and eggs. I used one. I've also bought some mutton. I'm very excited to see if this becomes an actual recipe that hopefully you can make at home too. The first thing that I'm going to do is boil two eggs. They're set to boil for about 7 minutes. Do not follow this recipe the way I'm doing it because I'm still trying to figure it out. But you get the gist. If it actually looks like ramen by the end of it, we've both won. This is actually my first time cooking mutton at all. I actually got a little bit of minced mutton from the store. And now I did not know if I had to wash it before I put it onto the pan or I did not have to. Hopefully I've done okay because I kind of washed it a little bit. I'm going to leave it to cook for some time until I think I turn it and it's not burnt. 7 minutes are up and I have to take my eggs out and actually put them in ice cold water because the guy on YouTube said that it was necessary to do. So I'm gonna take them out. Now that our eggs are done, we're gonna keep this at the side and start boiling our corn. Put the corn in. I'm not entirely. I've never cooked meat before and I don't think I want to. This mutton is, I don't think I'm going to pursue it. So now we're going to make a wedge ramen. The next part that we actually have to go to is our mushrooms. Now this is something he did not recommend to use in ramen, but I thought that mushrooms are fun. So I'm going to add a few mushrooms in there as well. Really questioning all my cooking decisions. Not that I have or know any because I'm not much of a cooker and the only things that I can make are like salads. Let's try that again. I'm going to let this chill for some time. My corn is almost come to a boil. I'm going to finally move to making our actual ramen. I had noodles, soup, powder, and flakes. Okay, now that my ramen water is almost coming to a boil, I have to cut some spring onion strips into really fine pieces. This is not fine, I'm going to forget it. If I can make it to the end of this video without cutting my finger. Okay, I'm gonna put my ramen into the water now. If you're a ramen professional and you're watching this, I'm sorry.
Wow.
I'm now gonna let it cook for 4.5 minutes. I'm gonna put my timer on. Our presentation almost begins. Our corn ready, our eggs ready, our mushrooms ready, our ramen's in the making, our spring onion is cut, I have gently pan fry my sesame seeds for like a couple of minutes. I want the ramen to taste a little lemony, and I don't know how this is gonna taste at all, so I'm gonna just cut a little bit of lemon, squeeze it in on top of my ramen when it's done. Again, if you are a ramen professional, I humbly apologize because I have not yet but almost butchered the ramen making.
A few moments later,
I may or may not have slightly, if anything, burnt my second ingredient slightly again today. Not happening. It's time for me to this is actually something that I have not successfully managed to do ever, is at least we know it was perfectly cooked for the ramen. Like I was saying, and like you saw, I've never been able to remove the shells of a perfectly boiled egg. It's time to start plating. I anticipated a lot less soup than there actually is right now, so a little bit of soup. And a little bit like Japanese style food is because I find it so extremely colorful. Ooh. Let's move this extremely watered one aside. I'm actually really happy about how this looks. And since we are eating Japanese food, I think it was only fair to eat it the right way. Aside from the fact that my kitchen is extremely messy, give me some credit here. Okay, now it's tasting time. Ooh. This actually really does remind me of the dhupka that I had in Himachal. Wow. Okay. A few things. Ramen in general, like if you buy store-bought ramen and eat as it is like Maggi. It's not extremely nutritious. So I do think that adding a little bit of wholesome ingredients just with it increases its nutritional value by a little bit. However, I mean, it's Maggi, and if you want to eat it, you eat it, but you need to try this. I think it was very quick. Okay, not very quick, but it was very simple. Maybe not extremely simple, but it was a lot of fun and extremely tasty. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. I will see you guys in my next video, which will be again very soon. Also, don't forget, I mean, what are the videos you want to see, or what are the recipes you want me to try? I will see you guys in my next video.